As NSSF and UNRA organized the contractors' conference in Kampala, the message was clear, encouraging more private sector players to save to grow the numbers. The appeal now is that contractors embrace public-private partnerships and work closely with the government.
So we use those savings to become capital, which we then invest and get returns on that capital. If the returns are competitive, we can use leverage to accelerate our infrastructure assets in a sustainable manner.
Minister Betty Amongin challenged contractors to consider enrolling their employees to saving schemes, warning that under the new law, it will be mandatory.
Drop, we cannot talk about monetization of the economy, which Honorable Kasaija articulated in the budget, when only 3% of the population is covered by at least one form of formal social protection and with low saving culture. Monetization of the economy has to go hand in hand with saving, but also to protect the vulnerable. The government of Uganda is responding to this.
Working through partnerships like UNRA, we create that awareness and the willingness to save. Have technology so it is easier for people to save. And then, of course, when push comes to shove, it will show. We show you the stick. We don't have to go there, but the point of it is...
The fund has partnered with UNRA to conduct a sensitization workshop for all contractors in the road sector aimed at exploring opportunities, implications, and compliance guidelines associated with the new NSSF Amendment Act 2022.